erratic suspect like this. Slow enough now, perhaps, for that pit maneuver
potentially.
Because he's really slowed down. Oh, almost got hit. That was a wreck involving the CHP officer. That is an extra added want on this suspect here. You saw that coming, that opposing traffic. It was a red light. Wow.
It'd be almost good to go back and look at that to see how that officer was hit, and hoping that officer is going to be okay.
Those vehicles are pretty tough. Those sheriff's deputies units, but still, that was a hard impact. And when those deputies are driving and they're not expecting it, then an injury definitely can occur. But
the driver too that hit the police vehicle.
Okay, now if you don't think that the officers wanted to stop this guy before, may see the officers escalate in terms of trying to bring this to an ending.
And this
just got personal for all of these deputies. Here we go, another potential collision.
Another near miss. And you can see this could be a situation where they do try to pit him. Even though those two vehicles pulled over, which is exactly what you want to do. If you see or hear something, try to slowly pull over to the right. Give the officers their space so they can do their jobs. Unclear if this suspect knows this neighborhood, why he or she pulled off on Avenue S, off the 14 freeway there, or it was just a random pull off. And again, we still don't have confirmation of what the suspect is wanted for. This could be a time where a pit maneuver could occur, even though the speeds are a bit north of 35. Again, 35 miles an hour
typically.
Yeah,
the problem is there's not a lot of place to put him. It's a cul-de-sac.
Try to pit him. There he goes. Here comes the pit into another car. And he's still moving. And he's going to continue on.
Wow.
That was a successful pit maneuver.
Look at the door.
The driver's side, the passenger side door is open.
And the windshield wipers are going. I mean, the car had to sustain some real damage in that, but the driver continues to go.
Two CHP units, or one of them may have been a sheriff's deputy, involved in that attempted pit maneuver. They pitted him, and then that vehicle went into a parked car in that cul-de-sac, debris coming off that vehicle. So you can see both doors are open.
Okay, here comes pulling into this here.
Wow.
A turnaround. Is he going to get out of the car?
Yeah, this is going to be a football. Two suspects. One's got his or her hands raised.
Okay.
He's carrying something, too.
Running.
And you've got to see how desperate this person is to try to get away after hitting these vehicles and an innocent person as well.
Is that?
Oh, no. Lock your doors, everyone. Lock your doors.
Okay. Wow. Look at this. Sheriff's deputies running.
You wonder if this is this person's home or not. I found it very interesting that there were so many deputies deployed in that neighborhood, and they had a spike strip ready at that exit, which might give you some intelligence.
However, if he did know that neighborhood, would he have pulled into that cul-de-sac area? We just don't know. This is is it a large apartment complex, or is it a? It looks like there's multiple AC units there. Oh, guns drawn.
A shootout.
Oh, wow.
Guns drawn. We don't know if any shots were fired or not.
And there are deputies running. A chaotic scene here.
Oh, man.
And again,
we see multiple deputies now with guns drawn. It appeared there may have been some sort of exchange there.
And it's really important as you watch this at home, everybody, because we have shown police incidents, good, bad, and otherwise, that have occurred. This is an individual that was running from deputies, running from the police. They lit them up. They told them to pull over. They didn't. They rammed a sheriff's deputy vehicle or a CHP vehicle. There was damage there, perhaps an injury. Then they got out of their vehicle and continued to run. Now, in this situation, they are giving this suspect strict commands to give themselves up. It looked like a male. I could not tell the gender of the other individual who immediately, when they got out of the passenger side, put their hands up.
So we don't know if that person is an innocent person who was being held by this driver.
Something just came from
somebody.
The top of that. Was that an animal?
Yeah, so you have to wonder as you look at this here about innocent people who are in this complex here, and you have to wonder if this suspect was able to get inside a unit, inside somebody's home.
And we don't know, it may be his home. We don't know or what his connection is to this place or a family member's home, or did he just run into a random person's house who's now in the middle of this, you know, very tense situation with guns drawn from sheriff's deputies.
It seemed like he was very erratic and just trying to get away. After getting out of that cul-de-sac, successfully evading the pit maneuver, hitting two officers and another one prior to from another vehicle because of an accident that occurred, and may have just pulled over to this location. Who knows? Right, so we don't know.
So when we look in closer, there's somebody on this balcony.
Yep,
we
the
don't
second
know
floor.
Who, two people yep. on this balcony.
They just
we don't know
be-
if they are the ones connected to this, if they're communicating. We see that the deputies have their guns drawn, pointed at these two individuals. Clearly some sort of conversation happening there, but we don't know, you know, what their connection is. So from what we could see, it looked like that other person who may be a suspect or may be an innocent victim, they've now taken into custody or talking to officers, doing something. But now the focus is on this person and what may be a family member.
Providing intel, they could just be some residents, because this does appear to be a two-story apartment unit. Just looking, it appears that those are individual AC units attached. The Antelope Valley, a hot portion of Southern California, even though we had the May gray here, it was sunny and 90 degrees or above there today. This now turns into perhaps a barricade situation. What deputies are going to do is they're going to try to set up a containment around this this complex here, and then they may have to go door to door and search each unit. Don't know.
Keep in mind that suspect was running carrying something. It looked like a bag or a backpack. You have to wonder now too if that suspect had some kind of weapon that they were carrying.
Right. It was something important that he wasn't going to leave behind, and he was going to run with it.
Or was it? Yeah. Or I mean, just throwing out there as a possibility, could there have been a child or something else in that bag?
Initially, that's what I thought as well, that it could have been a little baby. We just don't know at this time, because we've gotten unconfirmed reports about different situations which initiated this pursuit, and we still don't know that, Alex and Christine?
Right. Yes. And so we're waiting for more information on that front. You know, there's different things that are out there, but nothing is confirmed.
The position, though, of those deputies and those officers there, you can see that they are in a protected position for their own safety there. What they are watching, it's hard to tell. Is there a stairwell that leads up to an upstairs, or is there a ground unit that they're watching, a door? We do understand shots were fired.
Yeah,
trying to get more information to see if that came from the law enforcement officers.
It looked like it.
The suspect.
And it looks like that person on the balcony may have a shotgun as well. And this is now a standoff situation. But if you're just joining us, all of the things that we've seen in this pursuit just in the last 15 minutes or so, we saw a sheriff's deputy who was in a crash with another innocent person because the driver was driving so erratically. We don't know about the condition of that deputy or the other innocent car that was involved in that. We know that the deputies tried to pit this driver. At one point, the driver ended up getting hit into a mailbox and another car. Didn't look like anybody was in the car, but probably damaged that car. And then the driver kept going, pulled into this particular property, ran up the staircase. There was an exchange of gunfire at some point, very chaotic. And it looks like there's now either a negotiation, but I mean, this is a tense thing. And Rick, we often talk about, and Christine, we often talk about body language gives us our cues. And you can tell, Christine, from the body language here, this is a tense
situation. Very tense. They are taking cover.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can see they have their guns drawn there. And it's amazing to watch the people there on the balcony. It looks like a man and a woman watching what's happening here. Those deputies, those officers there in a protected position for their own safety there with those guns drawn. We're going to take a look at some of this pursuit of what we saw earlier. We have seen a lot of chaotic scenes in this one, ending up at this apartment complex here in the Antelope Valley. Watch this scene here. This is East Avenue as the driver there makes that turn there, and an officer right there hit by an innocent
person. That was a hard T-bone.
And you have to wonder if that driver, that innocent driver, is okay as well as that officer. But that's exactly the thing you don't want to see happen.
Yeah,
they're very scary.
That crash again. And then there was another incident not long after that. The driver tried to go into a cul-de-sac. Let's look at that. This is a dead end.
Dead.
So they think here's a chance
this
to pit the suspect.
The
suspect goes
into
Yeah, you think he's done, into another car, into a mailbox,
and he
gets away. So let's take a live look at the apartment complex area. It looked like what we were just seeing was that the officers, the deputies there, were talking to the other person that was in the vehicle out and where the car, where they got out of the car, and while this standoff is now underway.
And let's get back to the early information where we didn't know the exact want on this driver. There were a couple things along with assault with a deadly weapon. We saw that passenger run out of that car. And you have to wonder, was that person there willingly in that dangerous pursuit, or they'd already hit, or you saw the innocent vehicle hit the police vehicle? Or was that person being held hostage? Were they a victim as well?
Both doors we saw were open.
Right there.
So this is
Looks like the person that was in that car.
And if you notice, the person does not have handcuffs on.
And look at the body language.
Which leads you to believe that this person may have been an innocent victim in this situation, potentially some sort of kidnapping victim. Okay, now we're seeing
more
deputies running in and running in with more protective gear.
There's no question. More deputies arriving. And again, you mentioned it, Alex. It's all about the body language. This is a frantic scene. This is a very fluid scene in which a suspect
Look at all these deputies here now.
Where guns were drawn. The Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department is the primary law enforcement jurisdiction. As a group, look at this. They're moving in, and they're going to bring this to an end the best they can without anybody else getting it. But guns are drawn.
And their shields.
And again, we have reports that shots have already been fired. Fortunately, from our vantage point, we're not seeing anybody down. But I would not be surprised if LA County Fire rolls up just in case because of what we've already seen.
Yeah.
But that was a roundabout there pulling into this this living facility, whether it be an apartment complex, a two-story apartment complex here in the south end of Palmdale off of the 14 freeway, having exited this pursuit did at Avenue S. And now the reinforcements arrive. I would not be surprised if SWAT units came in as well.
A desperate effort by that driver of that was looked to be a Prius to try to get away from law enforcement, driving in the center lane there, getting on the freeway, then getting off the freeway. And you have to wonder, did the driver know this apartment complex? Was a driver trying to end up here at this location? The way they entered this kind of roundabout here makes me think that the driver might have been familiar with this location, and that driver ran to one location, and we don't know if they were able to get inside on their own or not.
And we don't know where this pursuit started. We don't have firm details on why it started. If it did even start in this area and then went north, and then we've seen so many times with pursuits, they get off the freeway and then head back in the direction where they came from. That could have happened.
So, Rick, and we now have some official confirmation of what we were sort of speculating a short time ago, that the original want here was a kidnapping suspect and assault with a deadly weapon. So that woman, we believe, that was in the Prius and that was talking with deputies a short time ago was, we believe, the victim of a kidnapping, which is why she got out of the vehicle, hands up, don't interact with me. And then the suspect kept running with that bag, which may have included a shotgun. And that's why there was this exchange. We don't know if the suspect is in an apartment complex with his family members or his own apartment complex. That's why he chose that particular spot. And we don't know if there's another innocent victim or maybe even a family member who's an innocent victim in that apartment complex who may be, you know, scared for their life right now.
Yeah, it's a tense situation.
And they brought in the heavies. You saw that. I mentioned perhaps we'd see some SWAT units, and there's at least one there, Special Weapons and Tactics, and they will be on scene there trying to bring this to an end without anybody else getting hurt. If we do know that there have been a couple of traffic collisions as a result of this pursuit. Unclear if any officers